Sugar prices skyrocket as farmers abandon growing canes. 60% of businesses close in 2 years, according to a new report. President William Ruto to officially open the 28th Uber Trade Fair. Consumers in Kenya hit by fuel and electricity cost shocks. And Tanzania mortgage market slows as housing demand rises. Once again, thank you for joining us on the show this week from wherever you're watching. My name is Simon. Now, listen, a few months ago, before Kenya went into the polls, we're talking about the presidential elections that happened. The president then, Uhuru Kenyatta, had put out what he called a subsidies on fuel. And this was meant to ensure that the locals could access fuel at a subsidized rate. Of course, at the time, the fuel prices were really skyrocketing. But this is just getting interesting because in his first week in office, the new president, William Ruto, stepped in and said, look, we need to remove these subsidies and move them to the production area. The lesson here is when the forces of demand must apply in the markets, it is only obvious that we should let them happen. And maybe it is something that Uganda can borrow a leaf from and learn that sometimes we don't need to dictate what is on the market. Just let those that have the money spend, and those that don't have will somehow find their levels in there. Because look, just 1 week, Ruto puts off the subsidies and the fuel prices are high again. And now the consumers are saying they cannot meet what was. Thank you for joining us on the show. This is what is coming up on the business show this week.
Yeah, during the Best Farmers competition, I successfully was selected as one of the best farmers and was allocated some finances, which I have to tell you that I utilized right here for the start of my industry. And when we went to the Netherlands, I cannot say I found sugarcane in the Netherlands. But what I found in the Netherlands helped me to adjust on my native crop at home.
Once again, welcome to the Business Show. My name is Simon, and like I keep saying, this is your show, so always feel free to get in touch with us and tell us what you think about the show. Now, in its sixth edition, the Chief Financial Officers Awards are back. This week, we want to find out what's new, the nomination, what it is focusing on. And this year, it's focusing on environmental sustainability and governance reporting, societal impact, and environmental transformation. We did sit down with the head of SCCA in Uganda, Charlotte Kankunda, who tells us what this means and also just how important it is for chief financial officers to take part. But the most interesting part is the focus this year is on environment. Let's take a look on views from the top.
Good evening, I'm Charlotte Kankunda and I work with ACCA Uganda as the country manager. And for the last 5 years, I've been leading the project of the Chief Financial Officer Awards, which we abbreviate as CFA Awards. It's an initiative that we started in partnership with Deloitte Uganda, and the whole purpose was to throw more light on this role or illuminate what it does in driving integrated thinking to support decision making and build sustainable business models as well as resilient organizations. There are many people who play a role in the organization, but the CFO is quite central to that because he leads the delivery of the strategy and he also looks at the profitability of the company and leads the reporting. So we felt the public needed to know more about this role. Some of the main objectives really were to recognize the people who are doing so well for their organizations, to celebrate them as well, because our membership is made up of people who have studied and a segment of them are doing, are probably serving the organizations in this role. And then we finally would like to throw more light on what drives sustainability in organizations. The sixth edition of these awards is this year, 2022, and I'm happy that we've never stopped since we launched from 2017. And its focus is on the ESG, reporting environmental impact and environmental transformation and social impact. And we looked at this as one of the, it's not necessarily the new agenda, but it's one of the areas under sustainability that would like to throw more light so that CFOs can embrace it, take the lead on it, and also create awareness for the local public that this is a critical area for their concern. In terms of categories, we've maintained the 8 categories that we had last year. And the reason is simply because we felt they're still relevant as they've been reviewed by the technical team and we feel they still serve the purpose for which we set out to recognize CFOs. We will also maintain the sustainability category, which speaks to the theme as it was. We launched this particular CFO award on the 30th of August and we've kept the nomination link open until next Tuesday, the 27th of September. We would like people to consider when they are making their nomination, what someone has actually achieved within the last 2 to 3 years, not only just about the theme, but also in getting all that the company had set out to do, especially in these disruptive years. Have they achieved it? In terms of what is new, really every year is new. When you set out to you know, recognize someone, they might have done something amazing last year, but they didn't get an opportunity to be recognized. So this year is a new opportunity or another opportunity for them to put out their nomination and be recognized by either their staff or themselves. You can even self-nominate. We encourage that. Theme this year is ESG, reporting, societal impact and environmental transformation. And this is following last year's, which was talking about finance leaders as drivers of sustainability. ESG is an abbreviation of environment, social and governance. And it really speaks still to the sustainability agenda because what we've learned over the last 2 years is you just can't make profit. You have to be sustainable and you have to be responsive to your society, your environment. You have to have the right governance in your company. And finally, the environment. And you all know now that climate change is a fact that is not only being paid attention to globally, but even on a local scale, we are already feeling its impact.
Okay. So why should the finance officers embrace these awards?
Why should they embrace the awards? It's important for you to be recognized for what you're doing well, what people gain in terms of what they're paid for what they do. It's the recognition, and for us as a body, a professional body of finance professionals, we look at recognition as very key for someone's career progression, for someone's career success. And when that is done, you're inspiring others because CFOs lead teams. Now, when the team that you lead, it is not a personal, rather it is a personal recognition, and it's not a team recognition, but in actual sense, you do not achieve this on your own. So you being nominated and recognized or winning an award as, let me say, the Strategy Execution Award, I don't think it's just you, the individual. You will have been supported by this team. So it's a motivation for yourself as an individual, for the team, and also inspiring the younger ones who are looking up to, you know, progressing to these levels. So we encourage people to take them seriously and get the recognition that they deserve. And even when you don't win, when you go through the process, there is a learning that you will have been taken through, because we have a judge panel or a panel of judges that really examines these nominations and goes ahead and interviews these people to see whether they are the best in that particular category. So for you to be interviewed and pitched against others, you get a different measure, because if you're in your own organization alone, you might think I'm the best. Then when you're put together with others, you realize, oh, I still have some work to do in this area or the other area. So it's a good thing to do. What has been the trend? Interesting question. We started out with less participants, and the trend has been continuous growth, I should say that. And the trend has also been an increase in the participation of young CFO category. So we recognize that we have a young population, and we've noticed that for the young CFO of the year category, the level of participation has really increased and is quite competitive. That's what really comes quickly to mind. Then we have not, we've also noticed growth in the public sector participation in terms of the numbers and the diversity of nominations that we get. However, we still feel the SME sector is not yet where we want it to be. And this speaks to our economy. We say that it's an SME driven, or SMEs are the backbone of our economy. But does it mean that we don't have professionals servicing this industry? Because we don't get as many nominations from the SME as we would like to. So this is a call to those finance professionals that service the SMEs in whichever capacity to identify the CFOs that are servicing this sector and participate. Then the other growth that we've noticed is the female participants. We've at least now started recognizing 2 to 3 per session or per award. We noticed that last year we had three awards that were taken by ladies. So for us that is growth compared to the first one when we had only one, and the second one where we had only 2 ladies. So that has been recognized. And as SCCA, this initiative was taken to the Africa region. So that for us is a big deal. It means that the initiative is actually achieving its purpose. And finally, we noticed that CFOs are developing, or they are being taken on as the top leaders, as CEOs of the organizations. So when we look at all the ones that won the overall category in 2017, 18 and 19, they are no longer what they were at the point of being recognized. They've already moved on to other levels, especially other bigger leadership roles. So for us that is growth, and it affirms what we say, that this is a role for training the next leaders. Nomination criteria is quite simple, by the way. First of all, one has to be a head of the finance function. Your title might not be CFO, but as long as you're the top head of the finance function within your organization, you qualify. You should have been in a position of heading the finance function for a minimum of 3 years. So it doesn't mean only within that organization, even if you have experience in other organizations, but it should have been 3 years, a minimum. You should be resident in Uganda, meaning you can be a non-Ugandan or Ugandan. As long as you're working for an organization and resident in Uganda, you qualify. Then the other bit is you must be a member of a professional organization in good standing. In good standing means you are a member of SCCA or CPA or CIMA or ICAEW, updated on their register. So we shall be very keen on that. You should be in good standing. And then finally, self-nomination is allowed. You can nominate yourself, or your team can nominate you, or someone that knows you can nominate you. And finally, we don't encourage those who have won previous awards to be nominated for the same category. So you can be nominated for a different category than the one that you won. That's basically the criteria. To the members of the public, you have so many people that you deal with. It could be your auditor, it could be your, you know, friend who is actually heading a finance function. Do not feel shy about nominating them. All you have to do is go to our link. The link is, you know, being shared on the, you know, bottom of this screen, and it's also in our social media, you know, publications. Then for those who work with your colleagues, please go ahead and nominate your colleague. But CFO, nominate yourself if someone is not nominating you.
So there you have it. Last week, the Central Bank Deputy Governor did state that they're looking into ensuring that businesses focus more on environment and not just profits. Of course, he was speaking at one of the events where Pride Microfinance did get a certification for them to walk that way. We're talking about business with sustaining of the environment as one of the key fundamentals that they are taking shape in. Of course, we know that Uganda Development Bank was the first financial institution to do this. And maybe the Chief Financial Officers Awards, this edition in particular, 2022, is simply moving in that direction. Businesses should look beyond making profits, because the question would be, what then would happen if you destroy the environment, but you are making the profits? It's just a matter of time before you realize even where you're making that money could be out. So it's important that we pay attention to environment as we continue helping the people through providing services. You're watching The Business Show with me, Simon. Feel free to get in touch by getting on our social media pages right below your screen. Tell us what you think about the show. But for now, we'll take a quick break. When we get back, this is what you can expect.
A debt is basically money owed by one party to another person. The aspect of it being bad or good entirely depends on the borrower.